In this video, we'll be looking at earth leakage current, how we measure it, and what we can do about it. And we'll be demonstrating some of the key points using the DCM305E earth leakage clamp meter from Megger, and seeing how it can make electricians' lives easier by spotting problems early in a non-invasive way. Now, we've all been there, haven't we? The mystery of the tripping RCD. It's likely that this problem is increasingly caused by earth leakage current. So what is that? Well, it comes in two flavours, really. The one that we're most familiar with is unintentional earth leakage current. You know, the type when maybe you screw back a socket front, you accidentally nip the line or neutral conductor under the fixing screw, or perhaps it's pressed against a sharp point in the back of the box, and the current leaks from the line or neutral conductor to the CPC. Or maybe an overenthusiastic homeowner has pinged a nail in the wall and it's gone between the line and CPC, causing current to flow down to earth and tripping the RCD. However, there is also intentional earth leakage current to consider. Now, that may sound really weird at first, because why would we want to intentionally leak current to earth? Well, to understand this, we need to think about the types of load that we're connecting to our electrical installations. Going back many years, loads were fairly simple and robust, mostly loads that relied on the heating effect of electricity, as in kettles and toasters, incandescent lamps, things like that. Or perhaps they relied on the magnetic effect, as in motors. Pretty much the most advanced piece of technology that would have been connected was what my nan referred to as wireless. That's a radio for the younger generation. But nowadays, we're far more likely, even in domestic settings, to be connecting up equipment that is much more reliant on electronics. And as part of their normal, natural operation, these are often designed to leak a little bit of current to earth. In fact, it can damage the equipment if they don't have a good earth connection to leak current to. Many appliances and pieces of electrical equipment need to protect their internal control systems from what's called electromagnetic contamination, or EMC. And they'll feature an electronic device called an EMC filter. These use what are called Y capacitors that connect from the live conductors to the protective conductors. It's such a normal part of life with things like IT equipment that there's a rough rule of thumb in the industry that socket outlets feeding IT equipment are normally kept to no more than 8 outlets per circuit. And it needn't be a PC or a laptop either. Everyday items like TVs, modern washing machines, dishwashers, even fridge freezers may leak a little bit of current to earth as part of their normal operation. It's not a sign of a poor quality or faulty appliance. They're designed to work this way. And this is recognised by BS7671 in Regulation 531.3.2, which deals with unwanted tripping. It reads, "Residual current protective devices shall be selected and erected such as to limit the risk of unwanted tripping. The following shall be considered. Subdivision of circuits with individual associated RCDs. RCDs shall be selected and the circuits subdivided in such a way that any earth leakage current likely to occur during normal operation of the connected load will not cause unwanted tripping of the device." It's interesting that it uses the expression normal operation for earth leakage current, showing that this can impact on our circuits even when everything's working healthily as it should do. It goes on to state in the second part of the regulation, "In order to avoid unwanted tripping by protective conductor currents and or earth leakage currents, the accumulation of such currents downstream of the RCD shall be not more than 30% of the rated residual operating current." Now, that figure of 30% is essential to making sure that our installations comply with the regulations. And when we apply it to the typical 30 mAh RCD we use to offer additional protection, it means that the total earth leakage of circuits protected by that RCD must be no more than 9 milliamps. So if you've got a split load board, then the earth leakage in all the circuits connected to each RCD must add up to no more than 9 milliamps. By sticking to this value, we make sure that nuisance or unwanted tripping is minimised. On a split load dual RCD board like we've got here, this can be achieved by simple measures such as keeping socket circuits on separate RCD protection. In a domestic setting with individual RCBO protection, you'll probably achieve this naturally. In a commercial setting where there's a high volume of IT equipment being connected, you'll need to limit the amount that can be connected to any single circuit. But let's see this in action. I'm here at a typical 3-bed detached house. It's not got very much in the way of fancy electronic loads, just the usual TVs, gaming consoles, a PC, washing machines, dishwashers, etc. And we're going to have a look at just how much current it's leaking to earth. So as this incoming supply has been split to feed two consumer units, I'm going to measure the total earth leakage current within the meter cupboard here. Now, when you first turn this clamp meter on, you may notice that it's measuring some current straight away, even if you're nowhere near any cables. So if I just bring in meter cam here, you can see there that we're reading about 0.023 milliamps there. And that's a really important thing to remember, is the fact that we're reading on the milliamp scale. So that's actually measuring about 20 millionths of an amp. It's probably just being induced by the Earth's magnetic field, and it's not going to impact on our reading at all. So to measure the earth leakage, you need to clamp your ammeter around the line and the neutral of the circuit that you're measuring. So here we go around the incoming tails. And what this is doing is it's effectively measuring the difference in current between the line and neutral conductors, which gives us the current that's leaking down to other places, mainly down to Earth. Now, you may be asking a couple of natural questions right away. The first is, why don't we just measure around the earth conductor or the CPC of the circuit? Well, it's because we're concerned with how an RCD sees the circuit, and the RCD only sees the difference between the line and the neutral. It doesn't monitor the earth current. It's also possible that the leakage current is passing out of the circuit via another path to earth, maybe down a bonded pipe or similar. So the most accurate reading for earth leakage current is really found by the difference in current between the line and neutral, as we're doing here. So again, if I just bring in meter cam, we can see there that we're getting about 7.7, 7.8 milliamps. And you can tell that's not a massive difference in this installation. It's well below the value for any one of the individual RCDs that we're using for protection. But what we can also do is track down and see which circuit is leaking the most current. Okay, so we're just going to work our way along the RCBOs here, measuring the leakage current and seeing what values we get. So because it's a little bit tricky and awkward to get the camera in here, we'll do these one at a time and just take some pictures using meter cam. So let's get started. Okay, so first of all, on the smokes there, we've got 0.85 milliamps there, 0.85, somewhere around that. It's fluctuating a little bit. And then on the downstairs lights, we're getting about 0.9 milliamps. Moving on to the first floor lighting, we're getting about 0.7 there, so about 0.7 milliamps. And now you can see on the immersion heater, we're getting about 0.79 milliamps. Now that's interesting. There we go. So that is the ring circuit that's feeding the rest of the house. So the ring final circuit that isn't feeding the kitchen and the garage. And we're getting about 3.1 milliamps on there, which is interesting. And now we're looking at the ring final circuit that feeds the kitchen. And you can see there we've got about 1.85 milliamps there. And then finally, we've got the oven, which is leaking about 0.2 milliamps down to earth, which is quite a good sign because the oven is actually on at the moment. And that's a fairly healthy result there for that. So we can see that the most earth leakage is happening from the ring final circuit that feeds the rest of the house that isn't the kitchen and the garage. And what we can do now is establish if this leakage is happening from a specific item that we may reasonably expect to leak some current to earth, or if there's an indication of a slightly damaged cable. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to nip around the rest of the house and start disconnecting some of the loads that are plugged in. And I'm pretty sure I know which one is going to be the culprit for this, because it just so happens that this is the circuit that has my PC connected and also happens to be turned on at the moment. So I'm going to go and switch that off first of all and see what happens to this value of current. So keep an eye on that. So there you go, we can see that that's dropped down quite a bit. That's down by about 0.6 milliamps now. So that's by turning off and disconnecting all the stuff that's connected to the PC. So that's quite handy to see that going on. So let's go and switch off some more loads and see what effect that has. So I've just been and disconnected the socket that supplies all of the sort of telly and AV equipment in the lounge there, and you can see that we've lost another 4 milliamps. So you can see we're losing a little bit of earth leakage every time we switch off those loads that are likely to be leaking that to earth. Let's see if we can find some more to turn off. So there we go. All the loads are now disconnected. And as you can see, the earth leakage current is absolutely negligible now, meaning that there's no problem with the circuit and the loads are just leaking a natural amount of current into the circuit, with, of course, the biggest culprit being the PC. When we disconnected that, we got that drop of 6 milliamps, you may remember. In other words, we know that the circuit is healthy. Now, I'm sure that you don't need me to spell out for you just how useful this could be, not just in commissioning and fault finding, but also in terms of taking precautionary readings, for example, as part of an EICR before undertaking a consumer unit change. We've all been there, haven't we? We've carried out a board change and circuits that have never had RCD protection before suddenly just won't hold when they're covered by the new protection. Well, this device can actually show you, before you ever disconnect a cable or install an RCD, what leakage current that device will see and if it's likely to trip when installed, meaning you can spot problems and work them into your plan and your costing well ahead of time. I think this is going to become an absolutely essential bit of kit for electricians. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you already own an earth leakage clamp? Can you think of times it would have got you out of trouble if you had one? Have you already used one to help you in your electrical work? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.